not a man's best friend. Twin brother is, and I'm more obedient anyway, because you trained me so well. When you say sit, I sit. When you say stay, I stay. And when you ask me to retrieve and then return, I bring it back with me. Favorite place to meet them was the food court at the Mall of America. Even then I wet my lips and whimpered my eyes and watched them catch my scent across a veranda. My jeans were skin tight and my thighs were still teenage, and all I wanted was a room key or a shopping spree. Sometimes I'd let a sucker hang out of my mouth as I ride the escalators. A smoke signal of sorts. An invitation to approach. An invitation to spoil me rotten. We'd go to all my favorite stores and they'd use their American Express black cards and chase freedoms and discovers to buy me whatever I wanted. No questions asked. Just an unspoken handshake agreement. Possible deniability until the deal was sealed. Sometimes we'd go back to their cars in the empty parts of the parking lot. Trick or treat, I guess. So a lot of lonesome pilot types would occupy the Holiday Inns and then the Quintas and the Marriotts and the Super 8s too. I'd wade past the disinterested concierge up the same burgundy steps over and over. It's the kind of place that will always smell like old cigarette smoke, no matter how you wash the walls. Bill would encourage me to try a new lotion. He'd buy a few bottles and take me back to his hotel room. He always stayed in the one attached to the mall, and I'd pretend to be his son if anybody asked. But they didn't. Kenneth had a big body, the kind I could hide under, and we would put his weight over me and crush me and enter me into the yellow light of his hotel room. One will call Adam insisted I swallow a mystery pill if I wanted to get paid. And I was terrified, but I did it anyway. Oh, come on, it's just Viagra inside. As if my teenage virility wasn't intrinsic to our transaction. Aching from a shallow throat. The guts of the mega mall. A mall is like a tooth, half hidden in the gums of the earth. And the roots are parking garages and fire escape routes and private celebrity entrances. One of the security guards I'd gain the favor of would play lookout for me if I wanted to bring somebody down to the depths. And all he ever wanted to do was watch. So I let him. I made myself a well, all for pennies tossed by strange men, open wide and seemingly bottomless, deceptively accumulative, rich with it. At the end of the night, I took my spending money in shopping bags and threw Vokajic Suite at the top of the Western parking ramp. One of my favorite places to recline and consider the perks of anonymity. And I'd watch the sun go down from the other side of the horizon would glow from the airport. And wait for my grandmother to pick me up. Aching from a shallow throat. Aching from a shallow throat. Aching from a shallow throat. Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat.
Aching from a shallow throat. A brief examination of your personal effects revealed all that was needed to build an airtight case against you. From the moon cleanse crystals to the cosmic pocket lens to your book on extraterrestrial archaeology. You were sent here from another star with a